It's Smith's trainer that won Trainer of the Year from Ring Magazine and Boxing News over in England. But Canelo enjoys the kind of relationship with his trainers that I think is beneficial in a fight like this. They know each other extremely well. They communicate very well in the corner, and they always have their fighter prepared.
And though they've trained no other world-class prominent fighters on whom to build the dossier, the skills that Canelo Alvarez has inculcated into his game are sufficient, aren't they, Roy, to show that Chepo and Eddie are quality trainers?
Yes, they're high-quality trainers. He does things that you don't see even many other Mexican fighters do. He's more of a boxer than a fighter than you usually see from Mexico. So I think they have done a terrific job of implementing all the good things, all the great qualities that he needs to be a great fighter.
It's something to bring a kid from a kid to a world champion, particularly to the top of the sport, on some pound-for-pound lists and the biggest draw in boxing. That ain't easy.
On May 9, 2015, 1 week after Mayweather Pacquiao, this man drew 31,800 plus fans to a baseball stadium in Houston. One of the reasons we're here tonight is that that particular draw suggested that he could draw another big crowd here in this football stadium. And it has in fact turned out to be the case. And it further underlines his current status as the biggest money fighter in boxing at this moment.
40,000 plus against an opponent who's not really known in the United States is a mean feat.
And the crowd roars as they have not all night long, other than on those waves, for the star of the show.
Canelo
the size of the crowd and the intensity of the occasion flashes a smile. That isn't always the case on his walks to the ring. Very calm, Roy, very self-contained.
Very calm, self-contained, self-confident, and ready for war.
Now let's go to Michael Buffer for the official introductions.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the home of the Dallas Cowboys, AT&T Stadium here in Arlington, Texas, serving the greater Dallas metropolitan area, Oscar De La Hoya's Golden Boy Promotions, in association with Frank Warren and Canelo Promotions, proudly present the main event of the evening, 12 rounds of boxing for the WBO Light Middleweight Championship of the World. Presented live on HBO Pay-Per-View and BoxNation and sponsored by Tecate, Born Bold, O'Reilly Auto Parts, better prices every day, Hennessy, never stop, never settle, Adriana's Insurance, el seguro que necesitas al precio que quieres pagar, AT&T, mobilizing your world, and Casamigo Tequila, it's in the taste. This contest sanctioned by the Texas Department of Licensing and Regulation, Chairman Mike Arizmendez. The executive director, Brian Francis, program manager, Greg Alvarez, and the World Boxing Organization, President Francisco Paco Barcarcel. The three judges scoring the bout will be Levi Martinez, Oren Schellenberger, and Nelson Vasquez. And in charge of the action at the bell, World Championship veteran referee, Luis Babo. And now the officials are in place and they are ready. The fighters are in the ring and they are ready. Boxing fans, are you ready? For the thousands in attendance and the millions watching around the world, ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble! Introducing first, the challenger fighting out of the red corner with his co-trainers, Eddie and Chepe Reynoso, wearing blue trimmed with white, officially weighing in at 154 pounds. His professional record, an excellent one. 47 victories, including 33 wins by knockout, with only one defeat and one draw. He's the former WBC light middleweight and middleweight world champion, still recognized as the linear middleweight champion of the world. Damas y caballeros de Guadalajara, Jalisco, México. Santos Saúl Alvarez Barragán, a.k.a. Canelo Alvarez. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the blue corner with his trainer, Joe Gallagher, wearing gray with black trim, official weight, 154 pounds. He has an undefeated record consisting of 24 fights, 23 victories, including 13 wins by knockout with one draw, and he has KO'd 8 straight opponents coming into the ring tonight. He's the 154-pound fighting pride of Liverpool, Merseyside, England, the reigning, defending, undefeated WBO light middleweight champion of the world, Liam Beefy Smith.
Canelo. Smith. Okay, guys, I give you an introduction in the dressing room. They have a clean match, okay? Good luck, God bless you. Le di la instrucción en el camerino. Vamos a una pelea limpia, que hagan el mejor. Dios los bendiga.
Liam Smith has the kind of aggressive style that has brought out the best in Canelo in the past. The question is Smith's best enough to make this more than just a showcase for Canelo?
Canelo. Unlike the vast majority of major events you've seen on HBO and HBO pay-per-view this year, this fight did not include drug testing by Voluntary Anti-Doping Association. That is because Liam Smith, who said he was being tested by the British Board of Boxing Control, declined to continue with BOTA testing after one test. Canelo, when he fought Amir Khan, submitted to BOTA testing and has done so through the last couple of years. So this is an unusual night in that regard, but the Texas State Athletic Commission has done their own drug testing and they say they're confident this fight is clean. Hard right hand by Canelo to start the festivities. And now sticking his jab. And the double jab. This is a pretty fast start for Canelo Alvarez, who often likes to watch and see what his opponent is doing in the first round, but has decided to take the initiative here.
Well, because he knows he's not the champ, Jim. He's come out to set the pace to let this guy know right away, hey, you're on my turf now. I'm the one that's in charge. I know you have the belt, But I am the true champ. I am the guy that everybody's here to see. So don't you get that twisted when you come in here.
This has been pretty much all Alvarez so far, sticking his jab, firing shots to the body, getting the early jump on Liam Smith. And now Smith begins to answer back.
And Smith has to get into this fight and see what it's like to get hit by a guy, a big guy like Canelo. Don't think he's ever been hit with anyone with the quality of punching power that Canelo possesses. So he'll have to get used to this first, then he can settle down and start fighting.
Is Canelo a 154-pound fighter with middleweight punching power?
Maybe even light heavyweight, Jim.
This is a good first round so far for Canelo Alvarez, landing several clean shots.
Canelo's got a very compact, you know, strong build, especially at 154 pounds.
Built like a 154-pound tank.
Looks very motivated tonight. Starting fast, putting a lot of leather on Liam Smith in the first round. Yeah. Canelo has already landed 19 punches by CompuBox count. There's still 47 seconds to go in the round. There's another body shot and the jab upstairs.
I think that right hand bothered Liam Smith. He smiled afterward, but it looked like it bothered him to me.
Oh, yeah. I think a lot of what Canelo has done has bothered Smith. It's a great first round for him so far.
Yeah, but those two right hands to the body, now three. Yeah, I think he's found a shot. I think Smith's going to have to take it away from him.
And Smith is grinning again, and this kind of grin says, you're wearing me out here.
Yeah, right. Smith's going to have to do something to dissuade Canelo from throwing that right hand to the body.
Great jabbing in round one. Great body shots in round one. Ring generalship, psychological command. Canelo over Alvarez has taken over in round one against Liam Smith.
Breathe.
¿Cómo lo sentiste, hijo? What you feel?
It's good?
All right.
Es lento, ¿eh?
He's slow, huh?
Es lento.
He's slow.
Tiene un movimiento peligroso.
He's got one dangerous movement. When you throw that left, he's catching it. You jab him and he wants to go in to get that uppercut. He's got a good uppercut, good left hand. Don't announce that jab. Don't fall asleep on it. Just because you hit him one, two, three times, maybe he's going to move and he's going to want to get in and get you. Work that jab.
CompuBox numbers in round one. Canelo 30 of 62. That's a flood. Smith 6 of 34. That's a trickle. So Liam Smith has to hope for a reset here in round two after being thoroughly dominated in the first stanza.
Problem for Liam Smith, who just looked outclassed in the first round, is that Canelo does well when his opponent opens up and gives him counterpunching opportunities. So Liam Smith's hands are home now, but it might even get worse if they leave home.
Well, Liam Smith's plan is to try to wear Canelo down, make him work, take the punishment. We just don't know if he's going to be able to take the punishment as long as he plans to.
I think Liam Smith's best shot is the left hook to the body.
It is by far, but he hasn't been able to land it yet.
Hasn't really thrown it.
But he's had to keep his hands at home on defense like that.
You think Canelo was motivated by the criticism he's taken in the past few months for not following through on the Gennady Golovkin fight?
Of course.
And if you're going to take a showcase fight, and I asked whether Smith is good enough to make this anything but a showcase, so far the answer is no, and that's a credit to Canelo. Smith's a solid fighter. But if you're going to take a showcase-type fight, you better showcase yourself, and Canelo's doing that so far.
Smith just landed a good right hand over the top, though, Max.
First good solid shot he's landed in the fight.
Yes.
And Canelo pauses to think about it just a little bit before starting to rumble again. Jab, jab, hook.
Smith's left side is turning red from those body shots, Jim.
Yep. Under the elbow, it's turning red.
Smith is a disciplined fighter.
Another hard right to the body.
He usually doesn't like to waste punches. He likes to land what he throws, but Canelo's the superior skillful fighter, the harder puncher. And he's being more active now.
Now Smith has to deal with Canelo's solid defense.
That's where Smith needs to stay, is on the inside. I don't know why he would back out to give Canelo room, because that's what you don't want.
Because Canelo's left eye, is there something on his left eye?
Yes, looks like there's a little nick right on the outside of his left eye, yes.
And it's Smith who comes into the fight with a cut in the middle of his forehead toward over his right eye that required 6 stitches.
Oh, good shot by Smith, right on that cut again.
Yep. That's...
So now, there's a narrative here, as Canelo has this mark above the left eye, and Liam Smith has a target at which to throw.
And I think Liam Smith is in his fight now all of a sudden.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Don't miss sometimes, you're boxing really well, all right? But sometimes you've got to be really big balls. Stay in there, catching, all right, okay? Lovely shots on the ropes, right hands over. But he's looked at a possum on the way in on that left hook. Keep it right tight to your chin.
Okay?
But don't forget, dip the shoulder and bring the right hook over, then the left uppercut, yeah? Always beware as soon as you touch it.
Here we see a small jab hit by Liam Smith. He threw 2 jabs and a hard jab. 1, 2, then this hard jab right here at the end, wham, and that's when the cut showed up. I ain't sure that's exactly when it showed up, but that could have been possibly when the shot happened.
Roy, it looked to me like the jab pushed Canelo's glove into his own eye.
And that could have happened too, Max.
And scraped the side of it.
That would be bad luck, but the cut is there, and Liam Smith now has a target to work at as round 3 begins.
No, it's gone now, so maybe it was something else.
Smith takes a big left hand to the body, but he's starting to smoke now, and I often mention aggressive fighters sometimes start a little cold and take a round or 2 pressure fighters to start to heat up.
Such an upper body size disparity here.
Yeah, he just doesn't look as strong as Canelo Alvarez.
He has big legs, bigger calves, but up top, Canelo is far more bigger than him.
Canelo momentarily trapped Smith against the ropes. Crowd got excited. You mentioned that Canelo likes for an opponent to come to him. In the first round, he went to Smith. Now the fight is settling into a little bit more of a give and take.
No, he went to Smith, but... You're right, but Smith is not fleet-footed. It's not a situation where Canelo has to cut the ring on a guy. Smith is basically right in front of him, so it's not as much of an effort for Canelo to come to his opponent in this case, I think.
Smith can't keep giving up those big jabs like that either.
Canelo gets in a hard right hand. Another right hand to the top of the head. Body shot with the left hand. Left hook upstairs. Right, left to the body. Excellent combinations by Canelo Alvarez.
Smith's never been dropped, but you take too many of those shots and there's a first time for everything.
A good left hook there by Liam Smith.
Yes, it was.
He hasn't thrown many punches that have meant much, but that left hook meant something. And there's a right cross. And there's the uppercut by Alvarez. You heard Eddie Reynoso asking him to throw the uppercut.
Canelo will have to probably catch Smith while he's punching to do some real damage. Catch him in between a punch, maybe.
Smith looks really conscious of blocking those body shots at this point with his elbows.
Very smart. He's got to block those down the middle shots, like the uppercut and that jab.
Got to block a lot of shots because Canelo's hitting him with everything. Good uppercut by Smith.
Canelo went for the home run with the uppercut, and Smith managed to counter.
Smith is definitely a live horse in this race.
Now,
didn't look like it in the first round, but and he hasn't won any rounds, but he's starting to do better and better.
Deep breath. You see, you're catching him with more punches now, all right? Now be careful because he wanted to catch you with that uppercut. You felt it? Yes.
Earlier we talked about how these two guys mirror one another. You see Mike Tyson's, Canelo go with the right hook and followed by the right uppercut, right? But then you see Liam Smith come right back with the right uppercut of his own, followed by his left hook. Then a right hand that fell short. But these guys do a lot of the same type of moves. Very similar.
You see the word autism on the back of Joe Gallagher's t-shirt and on the front of Liam Smith's trunks. All of the Smith fighters wear that word autism on the trunks in honor of their 12-year-old sister, Holly, who is severely autistic and greatly beloved within the family. Harold, how do you have it through three?
Look at Chip, I get it 3-0, 30-27, Canelo Alvarez. Chip, I absolutely love that left jab and that right uppercut. I mean, he really, really puts a lot of pressure on Liam Smith. He's just, you know, like you said, he opened up from the beginning of the fight. He started early, and he keeps moving forward, doing the same thing, landing tremendous shots. 3-0, Canelo Alvarez.
That Smith is his defense is predicated on his shell defense, on his elbows tucked, gloves up high, but it's not like he moves his head and slips a lot of punches. So Canelo just has to tee off. He's going to hit something.
Of course he is.
Okay.
And Canelo has the type of frame that even when he's hitting your arm or your shoulder, it's a not a clean scoring punch, but the opponent's going to feel it.
Now there's a mark on Liam Smith's face, a cut above his left eye, and seemingly that cut is in the same place where he was cut in a sparring session with Kell Brook a couple of months ago.
Seems like the same cut has reopened, Jim. I was just looking at it.
I said that Smith is doing better and better. His offense is present now, at least. But he's taking the same kind of beating in every round. He's just giving some back now.
While Smith is landing some good clean shots, Alvarez's punches still have more power.
Far more power, more steam, but this is what Smith wants. He wants a long fight, want to go overtime. He and his corner said that they think that Alvarez will tire down the stretch.
The body punishment in this fight is exquisite.
And that's what we expected to see.
Both guys will feel it to the rib cage later tonight.
Yes, and both guys are superb counter body punches.
Right, even if Liam Smith is right about Canelo gassing late in the fight, Canelo's body punches will even that out and bring Smith's gas tank low.
Blood just above the right eye. Liam Smith, there's unbeaten light heavyweight star Sergey Kovalev headed toward a meeting with Andre Ward on November 19. Kovalev had one draw in his professional career. Andre Ward brings a whole new meaning to the word unbeaten. He hasn't lost a fight, a boxing match, since he was 12 years old. And he's in his 30s.
You have to be careful with that guard, right? Keep your guard up. Jab, 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 strong jab to the body and up top. And look for this one. Look for this one, dude. If you're gonna stay in the ropes, try blocking, flex your waist, and lift them up with uppercuts and hooks.
A Kovalev versus Ward is the next big pay-per-view event of the year. Here's the big pay-per-view event of the night as we head to round five.
Kovalev Ward is the best matchup in boxing in quite some time.
Agreed. Probably to be surpassed in fan interest only by Canelo Alvarez versus Gennady Golovkin if they both keep going and the fight takes place. Body shot by Smith. Alvarez has slowed his pace since round one. That's allowed Smith to get into the fight.
Smith doing some good jab work early here in this round.
When Canelo fights, just as when Triple G fights, they're compared to one another. Smith hits Canelo with a shot. What would that be if Triple G landed that shot? Just as Cal Brook hit Triple G with some shots last week, and people asked the same thing about Canelo.
Two different things. Canelo, at this point, it seems, is more about precision and sustained punishment. Golovkin is more about extreme power and the occasional massive explosion. Now Canelo backs into a corner for Smith. Let's see what Liam Smith can do to take advantage. Uppercut doubled by Canelo, followed by the vicious body shot.
One thing you see a difference in Triple G and Canelo. If Triple G hits a fighter with these kind of shots through three or four rounds, the other guy's not still there. But the fact that Canelo is hitting his opponent with these shots is good for Canelo. You can see he can box.
He's a very authoritative puncher, regardless of whether he has as much power as Triple G. And he's probably a better defender.
By far better defender. Just not quite as an aggressive offender. Oh, good shot by Smith.
Yep. This is quite a rally. Liam Smith is getting better and better as the fight goes on. Some of that is the fact that there's no way Alvarez could have sustained the pace that he set in round one.
Well, his offense is. He's getting hit with the same shots, but at least he's giving back, and he's catching Canelo increasingly.
Now, Smith stretches his ankles every time he gets the chance to, like before the round starts, and right then when the referee broke him up, he stops and stretches his ankles. Really weird there. I never seen a fighter do anything like that.
Cramping, you think, maybe?
I don't know what it is, but he stands on the side of his shoes. Something crazy, and he puts his knees back like his knees are double jointed.
Smith setting up those big shots upstairs, little tap-tap shots. You can see he knows what he's doing on the inside.
Of course he does. Oh, good shot by Smith.
Hard right hand by Smith. His best punch of the fight.
Yes, it was.
As round five comes to a close.
Oh, he cut bad over his right eye, too, Joe. He's cut over his right eye.
And Joe Gallagher just came over and said something to us.
I think it was something like, when have you seen him hit like that? Never?
Lovely word.
Something like that.
Well, he got hit, that's for sure.
I haven't got much legs left in. I know we're in round five gone now, mate. Yeah. Watch the right uppercut, son. Watch the right uppercut, yeah? Touch up.
No, I'm taking me close down, you know.
Eh?
Can it take 3 foot?
No, I know, no, it's me. But just touch, touch, and really drive him in, son. Put him in. His legs are gone already after 5 or 7 to go. But don't be staying to it. And sometimes, just go to him and smother him. But watch that uppercut, all right?
Well, it's easy to see which corner is more relaxed. And Alvarez seemingly right at home. Liam Smith and Joe Gallagher are getting pumped up.
Joe Gallagher told him, watch that uppercut.
Smith's offense is coming around, and every round, the shots that he's landing are increasingly damaging, it seems, to Canelo, although he's still losing rounds by wide margins because Canelo is really putting it on him for most of the round.
Canelo's putting on a show, but Smith shows grit, determination, guts, and occasionally very hard punching.
Very tough guy, Liam Smith.
Yes, sir. Oh, good shot by Liam.
And he is catching Canelo cleanly.
Yes.
Counter rights and hard left hooks by Liam Smith. Canelo keeps coming with his body shots and his uppercuts. Uppercut, uppercut.
As can Smith's best be enough to make this more than a showcase? If it hasn't yet, it's getting close.
Body shot by Canelo gonna be real dangerous right here next if he throws one.
Why right now?
Well, because Smith is starting to show some fatigue in his arms and the way he's moving his body. He's so much focused on that right uppercut, but he's not really focusing on the body shot right now. So now would be the best chance for Canelo to try to land one.
Smith also throws good body shots in these positions at times.
Of course he does, but right now Canelo is looking for everything from Smith. Smith does not seem to be concerned about the body shot, or not as nearly concerned about it as he is the uppercut.
See if Canelo notices that.
The British have a term for heart and determination. They call it bottle. Liam Smith is showing some kind of bottle here tonight.
95% of them show that bottle.
That's who they are.
That's
they
exactly
have the spirit.
Who they are. Yes, sir.
Particularly the fighters that come to our attention internationally.
Well, you play them in soccer or football, as they call it. They run the field, and they never stop.
And the eye's bleeding pretty fusely now.
I don't know if that's a new cut or if that's the blood from the cut in the middle of the forehead.
The one from last round.
Listen to me. Hey. Calm down. Calm down.
Referee Luis Cabon telling Liam Smith to calm down.
Clean fight, okay?
I don't want anyone to calm down right now. It's a good
fight.
The referee doesn't want a fight to break out.
Great body shot by Canelo with the right hand.
Yep.
Halfway through the fight.
Okay. What's up, champ, baby? You okay? No, I know he is, mate. I know he is. Listen, you started the round lovely. Touching, touching, touching. Not every shot has to be a home run, son. Just keep him touching when he's wanting to go for a breather. As it pulls off, just touch. Watch him walking. You want a right hand or left hooks, all right? When you push him to the ropes then and he came at you, just step back, then fall short and counter, okay? Well, keep your straight arrows going, son. His hands are down here. One, two, three, slip, right hand, left hand, all right? And you got to every.
Solamente estás ahí con la cintura. Alternalo.
Mix it up. Flex your waist in combination.
Más izquierda, más
jab. More left, more jab, more straight shots.
Anna Berrigan, Canelo Alvarez's mother, has a nervous look on her face. Harold, how do you have it through six?
Yeah, look at Jim. I got it 6-0, 60-54, Canelo Alvarez. You know, Jim, in rounds, I guess 3, 4, 5, 6, Liam Smith has landed some nice shots. There's no doubt about it. But the problem is he doesn't land enough. I mean, if you watch the entire round and you say, who did more damage in this round, it's always Canelo Alvarez. You know, who worked harder, who threw more punches, who landed more, who landed the harder shots. That right uppercut is just a killer. And he works the body really well. I'm talking about Alvarez. I mean, those shots to the body have taken an awful lot out of Smith. 6-0, Canelo Alvarez.
I have to agree with Harold. I think those body shots have taken a lot out of Smith.
I think they would take a lot out of anybody. I agree with Harold that Smith has won every, or excuse me, that Canelo has won every round, but Smith has been increasingly competitive in the fight. He just doesn't seem to have quite enough firepower to reverse the damage against Canelo, who's been brilliant so far.
In the movies, Rocky Balboa takes all the shots and somehow comes
down
through.
Goes Smith, a big right hand over the top by Canelo Alvarez.
First knocked out of his career.
And the blood is beginning to really flow from above that right eye.
In real life, the plucky underdog takes a beating like that, he goes down.
And now those body shots will do to you.
The curtains are closing. The curtains are closing for Liam Smith. It's gonna be very hard for him to work his way out of this now. Alvarez with a big left hook.
Well, he's going to go out swinging if he goes out here, guys.
Better
the
believe
way
it.
You'll know how.
Better believe it.
Okay, okay, okay. Nobody throw.
There's a gusher of blood above Smith's right eye now. And it's bound to affect his vision as Alvarez tries to finish the fight with one hard right-hand shot, and Smith ducks it.
Those body shots add up.
You better believe it, Max.
Brilliant left hook. Alvarez trying to set Smith up for the kill, and Smith trying to reverse the fight again.
And that's what I like to see. A guy is likely to be knocked out. He's been knocked down, beaten up. Throw caution to the wind. Put real power behind some shots and see if you can't turn things around. Even if it hastens your demise, at least it gives you a chance. Canelo felt that left hook.
Smith is going to close this round with a rally. What courage.
Okay. I thought it was a body shot for the blow and the bullets. Okay?
Yeah.
Good. All right, let's just shot his ball there. He's pumping hard. All right, you've got to use your brains.
Here's the Canelo. Worked from the overhand right, landed, but the body shot did more damage. And then when the second overhand right came, he wasn't able to withstand anymore. Beautiful up and down work by Canelo. Once again, you see an overhand right followed by body shot, then a second overhand right.
Smith reached out and tried to grab Canelo's leg to keep from going to the canvas.
Yes.
And that makes Mama feel better. As we go to round 8 of a scheduled 12. Canelo Alvarez has won every round. He's knocked Liam Smith down for the first time in Smith's career that he's touched the canvas. He's busted up his right eye. He has landed an unbelievable assortment of hellacious shots, and Smith is still in there.
Canelo's also flashed a pretty good defense. Little of what Smith threw in the end of the last round landed. And when Smith has landed solid shots upstairs, Canelo's also shown a good chin.
And that was a good counter right over the top of a jab by Canelo.
Canelo landing more than half his power shots so far in the fight. That's almost always a formula for victory.
First time I saw Liam Smith move his head all night to avoid a jab.
He had to, Max. Those uppercuts will make you move your head. Those are vicious punches. So he's even throwing it now because he knows what he's doing to him. A good work with the left hand by Liam Smith.
Yes, it is. Canelo actually defending well, but Smith just smart on offense, landing some shots.
Very good left hand he has.
Significance of the event and the number of punches that are landing on both sides.
Oh, good body shot.
If this were a closer fight, it would have been a fight of the year candidate. But it isn't a close fight. As Smith goes to the canvas a second time on a body shot.
Been down by a head shot and a body shot.
Canelo's landed some just beautiful, vicious body punches tonight, and he stayed with the body.
Amazing work. Wonder how much more of this it's intelligent for Smith to try to take.
Right, well, Joe Gallagher has to ask that question of himself pretty soon. Smith's trainer.
He's 28 years old. He's still got a lot of his career in front of him if he wants to continue. There's no reason to get beaten to a pulp just in this one fight.
Okay?
Yeah.
Just under his elbow.
No, but in the center, so
open. All right, okay. Good breath, come on. Liam, so tight.
Jim, we talked about it earlier. You see three beautiful right uppercuts, followed by a beautiful left hook to the liver, as we talked about earlier. And most of the time, that's a bad spot for a person to receive a body shot. You see one, two, three right uppercuts, followed by a vicious boom right there to the liver. Bad, bad shot.
As Smith was connecting with a left hook.
Yes.
To the chin.
That may have dropped him in any round, but particularly after the way Canelo has savaged his body since the opening bell.
Any questions about Canelo's drawing power? 51,240 is the official attendance in this stadium here tonight. So Canelo Alvarez and Liam Smith draw 51,240, of whom Smith and his people were given the chance to sell 350 tickets in Great Britain. Round 9 of a scheduled 12. Seems to be a matter of time. Bloodletting at this point. How much punishment does Liam Smith want to take?
Another good body shot just landed, Jim.
How much punishment will his corner let him take?
He's already proven his honor. He's proven his courage. He's proven his will. What else does he have to prove?
They're fighting back viciously, though, Jim.
A terrific fight, Jim, and you're right. If they were more evenly matched in terms of skill and talent, it would be a fight of the year kind of fight. But all the pluck in the world from Smith just isn't enough. Canelo's on a different level. So this is either a amazing showcase for what it is, or something more than that. I feel like it's crossed over into something more than that, that Smith has given a good enough account of himself to say that this was a really good prize fight.
Oh, good body shot again. Shows you, too, that with a fighter like Canelo, it doesn't make a difference of really who he fights. He still can make it entertaining.
Well, particularly with a guy who's not hard to hit and who's going to come at him.
Fascinating how their styles mirror each other. Liam Smith is a lowercase Canelo Alvarez.
Yes, he is.
You put a guy like Kirkland, particularly without Ann Wolf in the corner, Liam Smith, a guy who's going to come at Canelo and be aggressive and show heart, and you'll make a great fight every time.
Well, this is why people are so
anxious. It.
There's knockdown number three.
That's enough.
That's
and
it.
I don't think he can get up from
that. Get up, no way.
Good, man.
Referee Luis Pabon waves his arms. That is a knockout in the ninth round for Canelo Alvarez. He fights a man who's never been knocked down and puts him down three times en route to the knockout victory.
And damaged him internally, which is why I feel like the fight, the contest, the competitive event was over after the last round. And this was the exclamation point, but maybe punishment that Smith didn't need to take.
Jim, one of my favorite combinations, taught to me by the great Sugar Ray Leonard, we were taught to throw a hook to the head, hook to the body. I mean, hook to the body, hook to the head. But Sugar Ray told me to reverse it and don't always throw the hook to the body first. Sometimes turn it around, put a hook to the head first, followed by a hook to the body, and the opponent won't be ready for it. And that's exactly what Canelo just did to Liam Smith at the end of that fight.
What an all-encompassing display of skill by Canelo Alvarez tonight.
Yes, it was.
Putting punches together in a wide variety of combinations.
Right there. Tap the head, bang the body. You couldn't ask for a better combination at a time like that, because when you tap the head, you take his concentration off of the body shot. He's no way ready for that body shot. And all of a sudden, bang, down he goes. Yep. Boom. High-low explosion. Tap it high, explode to the body down low.
And we've discussed this many times. The perfectly thrown liver shot is like an electrocution jolt to the body.
Yes, it is.
It takes away all sensation below the waist. There's no point in even thinking of getting up because your legs won't move.
Never will you recover from it in that fight usually.
Remember the promoter Oscar De La Hoya pounding his fist on the canvas after Bernard Hopkins, now his partner in Golden Boy Promotions, put him down with that punch. Let's go to Michael Buffer for the official particulars on the knockout.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes at 2 minutes, 28 seconds of round number 9. The winner by knockout victory and new WBO light middleweight champion of the world, Saúl Canelo
box numbers, and these numbers should reflect a technically brilliant performance by Canelo Alvarez. High level of accuracy, amazing level of power. Alvarez landing 37% of his punches overall. Liam Smith gradually was evening up the numbers as they went along after Alvarez got a huge jump on him in the first couple of rounds, but at the end of the day, Canelo Alvarez dominant, landing 45 more power punches, throwing only 12 more, landing at a 51% connect percentage, and as we've told you 1,000 times, you land more than 50% of your power shots. In almost every instance, you're going to win the fight. Liam Smith tried very hard and showed amazing courage, standing in against a hellacious body attack and some very skillful upstairs combination punching by Canelo Alvarez. Now Max Kellerman stands by in the ring with a guy who has just now won again, a 154-pound belt, Canelo Alvarez.
Congratulations, Canelo. I think the 50,000-plus people here tonight were treated to a good show. You came out in the first round and totally had your way with him, but he was able to get his offense going a little bit as the fight wore on. What happened?
Así es, como lo dije. Primero que nada, quiero agradecer a toda la gente que está aquí.
First of all, I want to thank everybody that's here.
Les dije que les iba a dar una pelea y les iba a traer el campeonato y aquí está.
I told you I was going to give you a great fight and bring you the championship, and here it is.
Contestando a tu pregunta, sí, lo empecé dominando, pero en el segundo round me lastimé la mano.
I started controlling him, but in the second round, I hurt my hand.
Me lastimé mi mano derecha y tuve que utilizar la izquierda más y la derecha nada más cuando era necesario, pero fue por eso más que nada.
I hurt my right hand, so I had to use it my left more often, and I only used sparingly my right hand, but that's what happened.
You were dedicated to those body punches early in the fight. Did you think they would be enough to score the knockout as the fight progressed?
Así es, así es. Lo sentí muy fuerte en los primeros asaltos. Entonces quise empezar a golpear abajo para ir dominando poco a poco y gracias a Dios me resultó el trabajo.
I felt he was very strong in the beginning, so I felt I had to put that body work in so that slowly he would dwindle, and I did my job.
What is it about aggressive fighters that bring out the best in you? Your most spectacular performances come against them.
No sé, yo creo que cuando se dan buenas peleas es cuando se acoplan los estilos. De este tipo de estilos, yo soy un contragolpeador natural y por eso es que me adapto a estos estilos y la verdad que lo disfruto mucho.
You get great fights when matches fit well, and I'm a counter puncher, and so I enjoyed it very much, and for this fight I did that enjoy it.
Okay, here comes the obligatory Triple G question, which you're going to be asked at every fight until that fight happens. Last fight, he also has an aggressive style that promises to make a great fight with you. After your last fight, I asked you about him. You said, "I don't mess around," I'm paraphrasing. And while no one questions your willingness to fight, your promoter seems reluctant to make that fight right away, and you seem to be going along with that plan. I think the boxing world wants to know why.
Mira, yo no le tengo miedo a nadie.
You know, I fear no one.
Yo nací para esto. Y aunque no le guste, a mucha gente no le guste, yo soy el mejor boxeador en este momento.
I was born for this, and even though many people may not like it, I am the best fighter right now.
Gracias a toda la gente por eso, y contestando a tu pregunta, hace aproximadamente un mes atrás, le ofrecimos lo doble o lo triple para hacer la pelea.
About a month ago or so, we offered him twice or three times as much to make the fight.
No lo queríamos decir antes de esta pelea porque le tengo un gran respeto a mis rivales. Y por eso te lo estoy diciendo ahora. Hace aproximadamente un mes le ofrecimos lo doble o lo triple casi para pelear. Nomás están que conteste y estamos listos.
You know, I didn't want to say anything because I respect all my rivals. But about a month ago, we offered him twice or three times. But we're ready. We're ready for him. And he just didn't want to accept.
Because you've shown throughout your career an almost recklessness in terms of who you will fight, even when it doesn't make sense that you'd fight a guy very dangerous without a big payday, yet you've done it. How do you feel about the fact that your promoter seems to have a plan that postpones the Triple G fight, and the fans, to some, looks like you're ducking Triple G as though you're taking a bullet for your promoter?
Como te dije, somos un equipo. Somos un equipo y no le voy a echar la culpa a mi promotor ni a nadie más. Somos un equipo, pero yo no le tengo miedo a nadie.
As I said, we're a team. We are a team. And I'm not going to blame my promoter or anyone else, but I fear no one.
Yo a mis 26 años he peleado con los mejores del mundo. He hecho historia. Y como lo dije, a muchos no les va a gustar, pero soy el mejor peleador del momento ahora. ¡Y viva México!
I'm 26 years old. I fought against the best in the history. I fought against the best. And like I said it before and I say it now, I am the best at this moment in time. Long live Mexico.
And I will point out that as a fighter, once Oscar De La Hoya got a hold of his own career, he never ducked anyone. Liam, obviously disappointed, although you couldn't be disappointed about your effort. What happened tonight?
It took Q for me, to be honest with you, Max. Like, you know, no excuses, but from my point of view, my timing was just so off. I haven't done much sparring, but that's no excuse. It was too good for me. I couldn't really land that on clean, and, you know, it's really just too good for me on the night.
Too good, too cute, too good, too skillful?
Yeah, definitely. You know, I was slow, and I had no timing to even make him think twice, but it was one of them. I thought I'd like, kind of take over late, but again, he was cute. I never really landed the body like I'm much to. You know, he caught the body shots well, and, you know, he landed his own.
Well, it was a very courageous performance, and I think the crowd appreciates your toughness tonight. Thank you, Liam. Jim?
All right. Crowd makes a little bit of noise there for Liam Smith, and you heard the discussion
about both this fight and the Triple G question. Roy Jones, you've seen a lot of Canelo Alvarez.
Yes.
You ever seen him better than that?
Nope, never seen him no better than that. Never seen him no more focused than that. You know, when you see a guy like Canelo who knows that there's a fight blooming in the background over his head, he always has to stay on his P's and Q's because everybody wants to catch him while he's focused on that other fight and try to beat him before he gets to that fight. That was a very professional move by Canelo tonight, a very professionally fought fight tonight. I'm very proud of him, and I still look forward to the big upcoming fight.
Speculate for me on how much of his motivation, and clearly he was very motivated tonight, how much of that motivation was about beating Liam Smith to win a 154-pound belt, and how much was it about trying to shut up the conversation that's going on among fans all around the world regarding him and Triple G?
We call it killing two birds with one stone. Kill the first bird to prove that he's still one of the best, if not the best, at 154 pounds, and to also show you guys why he thinks he still can beat Triple G right now, today, or any other day.
One final question. If, in fact, the fight with Golovkin takes place, that takes place at 160 pounds, 6 pounds north of where he fought tonight. What's critical about that is he'll be hitting a much bigger, stronger man than was the case tonight. How much difference will it make?
It'll make a lot of difference when it comes to the head shots, but when those liver shots dig in like that, it won't make no difference at all. I told you earlier in the fight tonight that the kid had to be careful and not to get caught with the body shots while he was expecting the head shot. As soon as that happened, you saw the end of Liam Smith, who has a big heart, who showed a lot of pride tonight, who fought his behind off, but just wasn't able to endure that ferocity over 12 rounds.
So no matter how big a puncher Triple G is, he'll have to guard his liver against Canelo.
He better.
All right, thanks very much, Roy Jones. Max Kellerman, more than 50,000 people here for this event. A couple of days ago, one of the major newspapers in the country wrote the obligatory "Boxing is Dead" column. We had more than 50,000 people here tonight. The conversation continues to build between Canelo Alvarez and Triple G. The next major super fight is clearly on the horizon. Exactly how dead is this sport?
Well, no, they've been the reports of boxing's demise have been greatly exaggerated for like 100 years now. There is a danger, of course, in having the kind of economic clout that Canelo does, which is that, and we saw this in the Mayweather-Pacquiao era, each fighter and each fighter's promoter used the other as the carrot to keep fans interested. And so they were able to juice fans along the way in pay-per-view events that the fans weren't particularly interested in, but after all, they want to see their hero fight, especially on their way to the big fight. You can see how much it bothers Canelo that he's perceived as the guy who's ducking Triple G here. And it's not Canelo. Canelo fought Erislandy Lara, Austin Trout, and others when it didn't make great economic sense for him to do it, but he wanted to prove he was the best, and he won close fights against them. That's not the kind of move of a guy who ducks. But as he said, he is loyal to his team. They have a business plan for him, and he's following his promoter's plan. That must be an exquisite kind of torture for Canelo to be framed as the ducker because he's following the business plan of his promoter. I think it would be unfair to call it a duck, certainly if the fight happens by Cinco de Mayo of this upcoming year. I think if it extends past that, which it may, it looks like it will, toward the end of the year, it's fair to fans to say, hey, hang on, this has already been ripe, don't let it rot. And if it extends past that, past the end of next year, then I think it's fair to say Golden Boy wanted no part of Triple G. I don't think Canelo, as he said, is scared of anyone.
If there were 50,000 people here tonight to watch Canelo fight Liam Smith, and if the Triple G fight took place in this stadium,
sellout.
I think so too. So once again, we came here to watch Canelo Alvarez try to make a statement after Gennady Golovkin made his statement 1 week ago in London. Golovkin produced his most inartistic performance in the last couple of years, allowed himself to be hit by combinations, or perhaps was outskilled some of the time as Kell Brook landed combinations against him. And ultimately, despite the fact that many on the web leaped to the conclusion that GGG had somehow been exposed, he wound up destroying his opponent in 4.5 rounds. Did Canelo answer tonight? Indeed he did, with technical brilliance, with overwhelming power both upstairs and downstairs, with a violent destruction of a fighter who had never experienced anything like that previously in his career. Next, Canelo has a date on HBO December 10, and 2 weeks before that, Golovkin has a date on HBO November 26th, so we wait to see the next trade between these two as they continue their war of statements headed toward what ultimately seems to be inevitable, the showdown. Thanks very much for being with us for this HBO pay-per-view special event.